Welcome, and thank you so much for joining the first year video for our mathematics programs at Laurier. I'm joined today by Dr. Mark Reeser, who is faculty within the department, along with Riley and Scott, who are two of our students. So we will do a quick introduction and then get started with some questions.
Hello, my name is Riley, and I'm a second year in the Bachelor of Business Administration and Bachelor of Arts with Financial Mathematics double degree.
I'm Scott. I'm currently in a Bachelor of Arts in Mathematics and also pursuing a business management option.
And I'm Mark Reeser. I am a professor in the department. I am the incoming department chair. So this summer I'm taking over as the chair, and I teach courses in statistics, probability, and quantitative finance.
Well, thank you so much for taking time out of your busy schedules to join us today. We really do appreciate that you're going to be able to share some of these experiences from your first year with us. So to begin, my first question is, as students who are in second year, first year wasn't too long ago, what do you feel is the most important part of each of your programs?
So the most important part for my program, and I'll talk more specifically about the financial math side, was definitely the labs that we got to do. So we got to go outside of our lectures and have like 35 to 40 students in a lab where we would have upper year students that the math department would hire, help us work on problems that were specific to the course we were taking. And I think that that was the biggest part of my first year experience, because it really helped you know how to do the problems correctly and how to study a bit. So definitely for me, that was it.
Yeah, so just to go on with what Riley was saying, the financial math program and the math program are very similar in the first couple of years of university. So the labs were a big part of the learning too. And then I just say another big important thing would just be just going out there and taking advantage of the experiences that Laurier has. There's a lot of clubs on campus, a lot of things to do, a lot of people to meet and relationships to build. So that would definitely be up there.
Okay, in terms of first year experience, I think it's really important to take your thoughts to the next level. There is a fairly big jump between high school math and university math, and it's not to be intimidating, but that's something that both Scott and Riley have touched on, is the labs that we've introduced at the first year, in the first year courses, are intended to help bridge that gap. So I think there's a really big learning curve that students go through in first year, not just in our program, but also in life. And if you can get through that with the help of these labs and some of the other supports that are available, I think that's probably the most important thing.
That's great insights. I'm hoping as well, as we start talking about, you know, in the next portion, what some of the courses in that specific first year workload is like, if you've had any experiences with some of the additional support that is offered within the department or the faculty, it would be great to hear a little bit more about that as well.
So some of the first year courses that you'll be taking will be calculus, you're going to take linear algebra, intro to mathematics for finance, those are just to name a few. The main support that you can get in first year, other than going to talk to your professor, is the Mathematics and Statistics Help Center, which is MAST for short. And what that is it's a room on campus. Right now it's operating virtually, but it's a room on campus where you can drop in at any time, and there are upper year students that can help you and answer questions for you. So it's kind of like drop-in hours. They will help you with homework, or if you're stuck on a problem that you went over in lecture, they can help you clarify that. So that for me in first year was the number one support that I used.
Yeah, so like Riley was saying, you're gonna be taking a couple courses in calculus, linear algebra, and for the math part, for the mathematics Bachelor of Arts, you don't need to take intro to math for finance, but you But for both of them, you do have to take Intro to Math for Proofs, or Introduction to Mathematical Proofs. And like Mark was saying, it's a big jump from high school to university mathematics, not to scare anything, but there are the resources like office hours and the math, like Riley was talking about, to use, to take advantage of, and you'll be just fine.
Yeah, I'll just add to that, as a professor, a lot of times when I have office hours, I find myself fairly lonely, and I wish students would drop in and ask me questions. So professors are quite available, and I know that students tend to go to the Mass Support Center, and that's a great resource, and also ask help of the lab coordinators and other instructional assistants that they have. A lot of the courses will have graduate students also hold additional office hours that they can help support. One other thing I'll point out is that the Math and Stats Support Center, if you want one-on-one tutoring, they actually will provide a tutoring matching service for students that are looking for some additional support. So there's lots of ways that we support student success here at Laurier.
I think one concern we often get from incoming students or prospective students is that intimidation factor of knowing that there is going to be a jump from what high school was like to university. But one theme that I hear across all programs is that there's support to help with that transition. And Dr. Reeser, you're not the first person to say they get lonely in their office hours. So I think it's important to take advantage of talking to your professors. Yeah. Now, I know Laurier specifically prides itself on enriching the learning through additional opportunities within each program and the university as a whole. So I'm wondering if you would be willing to touch on some opportunities that you've either had that you found really exciting or interesting, or ones that you have coming up in the next couple of years that you're really looking forward to.
Yes, there are a ton of things that you can do here at Laurier, especially within your program and even outside of it, but in the field that you're studying. So a big part of the math department, like we were saying earlier, is those labs. And as an undergraduate student, you are able to apply to be an instructional assistant within those labs. So the people who help you in first year, you can become that person in second year. That's a great way to get involved. It is a paid position, so that's always nice. It definitely helps. And it helps you also relearn the basics that you're learning in first year, because you're constantly looking over that material. So I definitely recommend that. There's also something that I'm actually going into right now, which is co-op. And I'm going into risk analysis in my co-op position, which for financial mathematics, that's like exactly what I want to be in. So those types of things are amazing, and Laurier has one of the nicest co-op programs that you can get into. And I know that even in the math department, like, you have that option to go into a co-op, so I definitely recommend looking into that as well.
Yeah, exactly. Being an instructional assistant is right after, when they hire really early in the second year, so you can help out right away and make some money as well, which is awesome. And co-op as well, I'm in the co-op program searching for some co-op opportunities, which is a great way to, just because of the how good Laurier's co-op program is. Another thing you could do if you're interested in is potential research opportunities, and Mark probably knows a little bit more about that, so I'll let him take it from here.
I do, yeah, thanks Scott. In the fourth year, we have a capstone course for math students that's essentially you work on a research project over the course of the full year. You get a half credit with one-on-one, you work one-on-one with the professor. That's not one of the paid positions, but it's an interesting thing that the students generally look forward to. There's also the opportunity to get hired as a research assistant. Professors have, in our department, we have lots of different grant sources and lots of different jobs that need to be done, from analyzing data to helping write, typeset a paper and things like that. And those are things that we hire undergrad students to do from time to time, as well as grad students. I know myself, I've got a couple of ongoing research projects with industry that I've been able to get a couple of undergrad students involved in those projects over the years. So that's something that's available to the students as well. One final thing is that we have a program and not called an undergraduate student research assistantship. And these are funded by the government and also by research professors. And it allows students to work for 4 months full time on a research project as undergrad students. And that can also count as a co-op placement. So that's another opportunity that many of our students take advantage of.
I think one thing to touch on with these opportunities that you've had is, especially as you're preparing to graduate, which I know that seems like it's so far down the road, but it's only a couple of years away. These experiences really help to build your resume and gain experience that you'll be able to take with you upon graduation. And it's great to see that you both are taking advantage of those. Okay, this is the hardest question that I'm going to ask you today, so I hope you're prepared for it. I know that it's going to be near impossible to pick just one, but I'm wondering if you could tell me what your favorite first year memory as a Laurier student is.
Oh dear. Okay, I'll stick in the realm of mathematics as we are doing that, which is kind of funny. So during my first year, I had this professor, his name was Dr. Chester Weatherby, and I had him for both my Calculus 1 and Calculus 2, like two semesters over. And the funniest thing that I thought, at least, and it's a great memory, is for when we transitioned from Calculus 1 to Calculus 2, there was two professors, but Dr. Weatherby's time was like at, I think it was at 12:30, whereas our other professors was at 8:30. And so we had people trying to sneak into the other math class just so they could get the 12:30 time. I mean, Dr. Weatherby is a great professor, so they might have wanted him as well. But I just remember so many students being like, I don't want to do the one at 8:30. Please let me in. But we had people sitting in the aisles that he had to be like, if you are not registered for this class, you need to leave. And I was so thankful that I was registered in that one.
Yeah, I was sometimes found it hard to get a seat in that class too. My best mathematics experience while at Laurier, I think, would have to be doing really good on one of my midterms. It was for a proofs course. It's completely different than you would have seen in high school. Like, the math is very new. So when I first was taking the course, it was very stressful because you haven't done it. But I put in a lot of hard work, and kind of getting that mark made me reassure that if you put in the work, if you go to office hours, if you go to the mass, if you take advantage of your resources, you will succeed. So,
yeah. How about a favorite non-mathematics memory, just because that's always so fun?
Oh dear. Okay. Favorite non-mathematics memory in first year, probably Hawk Weekend, which Hawk Weekend is something run by residents, and it's all of the residence buildings plus Locus, which is our offline or our off-campus student group, they compete in this like a big tournament weekend event, and all of the campus councils and the buildings themselves, they throw this event on, and all the students and residents get to participate. And I just remember being all like decked out in my building merch and just like screaming at the top of my lungs and doing all these chants. And we're actually going into Hawk Weekend soon for this semester or for this year, so I'm excited that that's coming up. But for my first year non-math or just Laurier in general, that weekend definitely was a big highlight.
I think I'm gonna have to go with Riley on this. Hawk Weekend, awesome experience. And then there's so many other things that Laurier runs throughout the year that are very fun as well.
And what about you, Dr. Reeser? Do you have a favorite memory, maybe from teaching, or something you love about working with first-year students?
Sure. There's a couple things. One thing I really like doing on a nice fall Saturday afternoon is going to watch the football team play. That's something that I really enjoy. And my first year at Laurier wasn't all that long ago. I came to Laurier about 5 years ago, and the first fall that I was teaching a class, one of the students, I was teaching Stat 259 back then as well. One of the students at the start of class that came down, she was a girl, that she came down and said, sir, you look exactly like one of my dad's friends. And of course, I've got a brother that's roughly the same age that had a daughter that was roughly the same age as this girl. And I was like, okay, it's going to be a picture of my brother. But it turns out it was some other guy that she showed me a picture of. And I did look, we did look very similar. And it turns out that was on my birthday when that happened, which really made me feel young that day. So.
That's a funny memory. I love it. I always love hearing the stories that students get to share with me, just because it reminds me why Laurier has such a great community and why so many students are so happy that they chose to come here. So I do want to thank you once more for taking time out of your schedules. I know it's very busy and your workloads are certainly not light, so it means so much to me, as well as the students who are viewing these videos. I also want to thank everybody who decided to watch this video. Hopefully you found the stories from Riley and Scott wonderful, and that's going to help you with your decision-making process of coming to Laurier and choosing a program. So thanks so much, everybody.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You hope to see you here in the fall.